Today we are here at Shri Ram Universal School, and with me we have the principal of the school, Ritula Singh. Welcome, ma'am.
Namaskar, people.
Namaskar. I would like to know that can you describe the vision for the school and how do you think your school is different from the rest of the schools in the region?
When we talk about the vision of the Shri Ram Universal School, Sheetal, I like to say that most of the schools where I have worked earlier, I've been into the education industry for nearly 30 years, the vision focuses on the child. But here we realize that learning happens only when you are providing a good environment to the child. And that is why our vision is that we provide a vibrant, nurturing, and creative and innovative kind of an environment to the child. Because learning is only when you are interacting with the environment. That is how anybody is learning. So once you give that environment to the child, automatically the learning will happen. So our focus is not on the child per se directly, but on the environment. And that is why you will find that all my children who are here, they are very comfortable. They are very happy coming to school. As quoted by one of my parents, the happiness quotient of my school is very high. So that is how we are, I must say, a little different from usually the other schools. I'm not talking about Jammu schools, I'm talking about schools otherwise also. So children love coming to school because of the environment that which is being provided to them.
Ma'am, I would like to know that how important do you think are grades and extracurricular activities in the development of a student? And especially, like, does the curriculum of Shri Ram Universal School helps in that overall or holistic development of students here?
Grades are important. I will not say, because we are living in a society where grades decide a lot many things.
Indeed.
But at the same time, what is important is when you are stepping out. I have seen this, and I think many people know this, that when you step out into the world, it is not just your grades which are carrying you forward. It is your all-round development of the personality which is actually making a lot of difference.
Yes.
So here at Shri Ram School, what we do is right from the beginning, if you see, right from Nanne Kadam, that is the pre-nursery, we have a culture where the children are taught 3 C's. They are taught communication, they are taught collaboration, and they are taught creativity. So what happens is they sit in groups, they discuss with each other, and as a result what happens is there is a beautiful communication. They are learning to communicate with their peer, which is probably helpful when they grow up. Apart from that, we have something called as a DEED, that is debate, elocution, extemporane drama, wherein again the children are given an opportunity to get onto the stage and speak. And something which is very unique to Shri is that every child gets that opportunity. It is not selected few, but every child is told to go onto the stage and they are supposed to be participating, and without even realizing, they do it, and they do it beautifully. I've seen within 1 year, there is a tremendous change within the child who's come to us, and within that 1 year, the growth has been exponential. It is beautifully the way they are communicating, the way they are talking, the way they are expressing themselves. Because what is important is that you should be able to put your idea across in the right manner. So that is what we are doing. A holistic development is happening. We are focusing on sports. We are focusing on extracurricular activities. Like, we have music, we have we have dance, we have various other activities which are happening. So children are exposed. Like I said, environment is important. We are giving that environment to the children where they are getting exposed to various kind of activities at the same time.
Yes, we did notice the amphitheater that you have for little kids.
Yes.
And for the rest of the students also.
Yes.
And ma'am, I would like to know, what's the student teacher ratio here?
We are actually, right now we have pretty less, but our focus is to have 1:12. That is, one teacher versus 12 students. That is the student teacher ratio, which is followed, entire Shri is following that.
For the other grades also?
Yeah. All of them. That is the student teacher ratio we are following.
1:12.
Yes.
Okay. That's really nice, because every child in that manner does get an opportunity
to express themselves.
Yes,
yes.
Ma'am, the next question that I would like to pose is, do you think that teacher teaching strategies regarding a good learner and a student who is a slow learner can actually affect his or her mental capacities? And also, how do you think that how important it is for a teacher to be considerate and compassionate towards student, given the fact that people or students especially, they are into stress these days a lot?
It's extremely important because, see, these years, if you see, start from NK and go up to 7th, 8th, 9th, these are the years where the self-esteem of a child is built.
Yes.
Knowingly or unknowingly, we adults really, badger the self-esteem. We don't even realize that we are doing it. What we do at Shri is, a gifted child is not made aware that he's gifted. The teaching strategies are such. At the same time, a slow learner is not isolated. What we call as inclusive education.
Okay.
That within the same class, you will find a person who's gifted. And you will also find a person who's a slow learner. Now, herein comes in our strategy of making them sit in groups. When they sit together, a group of three, they might be a gifted learner and they might be a slow learner. So when, the gifted learner will help the slow learner out. So as a result, because of the peer learning, peer teaching and learning, they learn fast. And at the same time, the gifted person also realizes he's got a responsibility towards the slow learner as well. So it really benefits a lot to the children per se. They really do a good job of it. Like I have seen, and it so happens at times, one person may be very good. Like you may be good in English. I may be good in math. Somebody must be good in Hindi. So when we put them together, you help me with English.
Yes.
I help you with Hindi. So that really helps, and without any, making it very obvious, the self-esteem is kept intact. So that really helps the growth of child. At no given point of time do the children feel that I am less than somebody else. That's the beauty of the Shri system that we have. I remember initially we used to make them sit in rows, but then we were told categorically that it has to be in group. You
inclusive,
have to
be inclusive.
Yeah.
It has to be inclusive
and sit in groups.
The role has to be played by the
students as well as the teachers. Yeah. The teacher just facilitates. She just goes onto her side, just guides and goes onto her side. So we truly follow that philosophy of that this teacher is no longer a sage on the stage, but she's guided by the side. So that is what we really follow. And it's important. The teachers need to get into that system. They need to understand their role. And accordingly, they need to work on this. So it's extremely important because that's where you're building children.
Yes. And ma'am, I would also like to know that which all activities school has been doing to involve students with the community to make them better humans, because school is actually residing in a very, difficult state to deal with. So how is your school contributing towards it?
Yeah, we have a program called Community Outreach, wherein the children have, last year during Vaisakhi, children went out, they interacted with the farmers. They actually prepared a survey, they carried out that survey with them, and they interacted with the farmers to have the ground reality of how difficult it is. Apart from that, they have been doing many other activities. They've been doing Shri March, and I would like to also mention here that our school is one of the first schools in India who's who's actually getting the rota kit, which is the junior wing of Interact Club. So our school is going to be getting that installed here. So that is one of the big achievements that we have over here.
Okay, and how do you, since it is situated in a lush green environment, so students do have an opportunity to, feel the nature. And I would like to quote here, Vandana Shiva, she said that the more grounded or the more related to you are to nature, that is what really helps you to, grow in a real manner. What do you have to say about that?
Yes, each child of mine on their birthday plants a tree. They bring a tree, they plant a tree. Any tree that you find around here has been planted by one or the other child of mine.
I would really like to congratulate you on that, because this is really a good initiative to inculcate such good things in students to, plant trees and to be aware of the environment they are living in. And ma'am, I would like to know that when is the admission process going to start and how people can reach out to you?
Sheetal, our admission is already open. We already have got quite a few admissions, and for admission, you just need to come and visit the school, because we insist upon that. The child should also come because he should know what school, or he should like the environment. Once you come, you register. After that, till class 1, we have a skill-based assessment, and from 2 upwards till 7th, we have a competency test, and based on that, we grant admission to the student.
Ma'am, we also saw that you have a parent relation counselor here. So you would like to elaborate on that?
Yeah, we have a parent relation manager. The sole responsibility of the parent relation manager is to take the parent right from the admission stage to initial settling of 6 months. So she follows every parent from the time of admission till the parent is settled for 6 months. After that, we leave it to the next stage. So the parent is taken good care of. It's not that, you know, once admission is done, everything is forgotten. She is continuously in touch with the parents to make them settle down. So that's the role of PRM, Parent Relation Manager.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving us your time. And we hope that more and more parents and students, they come here and enjoy the lush green environment the school is situated in. And we wish you all the very best for your endeavor and all the very best for school to achieve much more. And hopefully in near future, we will see school really doing well.
Thank you so much for your wishes.
Thank you.